The Fremantle-Richmond game today, Joey. I said the game of the year for Sydney Essendon, but the finish to this game was one of the best finishes for the season.
It was. The intensity of the crowd, the intensity of the game was awesome. It was a gutsy win by the Fremantle Dockers. No one really gave them a chance. Kingy without Nat Fyfe for the year, without Michael Walters, Alex Pearce, their star defender, also didn't play. And it looked like they were going to shoot themselves in the foot. They were 2 goals 12, I think they got out to at one stage. Definitely 2 goals 10. It could have really got in the psyche of their head because it's been an issue for Fremantle all year. But they dug deep. They hung in there. They just ground out a win. And Richmond kept coming. Richmond were pretty good, but led again by their young superstars. And old Benjamin Button there, David Mundy, continuing to... He's having his second best season statistically in his career.
So I just
35.
Want to have a look at what they did in terms of handling the heat that Richmond brought at them. Crunch moments in the game. OK, under serious pressure, Richmond have broken teams for the past 5 or 6 years. Young fella, just gets that handball out, gets some space into the game. Same thing again, handles the heat. Separating handball, 5, 6, 7 metres, and then they're away again. So that's what Fremantle were able to do when Richmond bought the heat, and then they flipped it the other way. When the Tigers got it, they come from everywhere. They really did. It was the hairs on the back of the neck stuff. You know, bang, tackle from nowhere. Won the ball back. And when you look at scores from turnover, which is everything in the game, it says you're either playing the right way or you're not. 2 goals 3 to 4 goals 7. That was the gap in the game. And I know the Tigers caused more turnovers, but when Fremantle gave the ball up, their pressure was so good to win it back and not pay a price on the scoreboard. I thought it was the best I've seen them play for a long time. Not that it was pretty or that it was sexy. It didn't necessarily, and there's a couple of really good contributors, but it didn't necessarily have Nathan Fyfe separate the game or David Mundy just, you know, individually separate the game. So as a team, as a collective, I thought the best they played for quite some time.
No Fyfe.
Yep. Yeah. What, and the last 5 minutes, really. I mean, it was an intense final 5 minutes, and there was one player that stood out to me watching this game, and we'll just flick up a few of his highlights. He was involved in those two passages of play as well, but you look at the time, the score, and the impact that Andrew Brayshaw had. I mean, up until this point, he'd already had a monster game. He had a career-high 39 disposals, 10 score involvements, 12 tackles and 8 clearances. But this is what I loved about this young leader. The impact in the big moments, late in the game, the composure with the ball, his effort. Just have a look at this. Bang, just full-chested. He was nailing blokes left, right and centre. And then the final couple of stoppages, he took it upon himself to say, I'll be the man. I'm not going to cough it up. I'll be the hit too. The final couple of clearances, he made sure he cleared the area. I mean, we talk about Sam Walsh, who's 21 years of age and taking the competition by storm. This fella's only 4 months older than Sam Walsh. And I think what he's doing has been underrated this year. He has had an enormous season for the Fremantle Dockers. Even Chera today at a career-high disposals. Hayden Young as well. But Andy Brayshaw, he's got leader written all over him. And I just thought that was an awesome final 5 minutes from him.
Just on the Brayshaw discussion. So without Fyfe in the team, when Fyfe's been out, round 13, 29 disposals, 6 clearances. Round 15, 24 disposals, all quality. Round 20, 39 disposals, 12 tackles, 8 clearances. Yep. I just wonder whether you can look at a slight shift now in Fyfe's role when he is to return. Because it's a bit like the Darcy Parris discussion for me. Yep. Just play them where they're super strong and fill the edges if you have to. Maybe at the expense of allowing the Brownlow medalist to be another Brownlow, you know, win another Brownlow. So, look, he's a star, this kid, and he's taking this football club places.